Imagine how digital can save a physical object. What is unique about digital to represent heritage to the visitor that other means cannot? Can digital save money? How does digitalization help heritage in war? Can digital transformation help transform the post-Soviet system of governance? Why do all of this during wartime? Digitalization can help, and I'll show you how, at the specific archaeological site of Tustan and on a national scale, and during the war. My name is Vasyl Rozhko. For 19 years, I have taken care of the Tustan, a unique archaeological site in Ukraine, where a wooden fortress was built on the rocks in the Middle Ages. First and foremost, Tustan is unique because of its construction technology. The builders created a real skyscraper, brilliantly using natural rock walls, which were completed with wooden structures and formed an impregnable fortress. We know about this thanks to more than 4,000 traces hollowed out in the stone. There are the spots where the walls, roofs, and floors were attached. And because of them, the lost fortress can also be recreated with high accuracy. This unique medieval monument was discovered by my father, Mykhailo Rozhko. He spent 33 years researching it, conducted measurements and archaeological excavations, created graphic reconstructions of the lost fortress. After his death, I continued his work by setting up and heading the Tustan State Historical and Cultural Reserve. We wanted to make Tustan known and close to Ukrainians and the world, so we launched the Festival of Ukrainian Medieval Culture Tustan, which allowed every visitor to plunge into the life of the fortress. Together with our team, we managed to turn a distant mountain village into one of the top tourist destinations in Ukraine, receiving 200,000 visitors annually. The area is being developed as a heritage-based museum and tourist cluster. The state reserve, local businesses, and the community successfully cooperate here. Cultural heritage serves as the core of the destination's development, uniting the medieval fortress of Tustan, the Boyko village of Urich, the historically formed landscape, the resistance movement, oil production, and nature. First of all, Tustan is a high-rise wooden fortress, which existed on the cliffs of Urich in the Middle Ages. Mykhailo Rozhko was the first to recreate it graphically, following comprehensive architectural and archaeological research in 1971-2004. The researcher left a series of drawings and pictures of different periods of the fortress from various perspectives. The question arises, how to work with the architecture of an object that does not exist anymore? If all we have are hand-drawn paper pictures and sketches of reconstructions, how do we build sections and perspectives, calculate volumes and structures? As an architect by education, I immediately thought of 3D, computer modeling. Today, this is the only available option for understanding the architecture and periods of the fortress. Its imposition on the rocks, analysis of the structure, technical drawings or specifications. We started by modeling rocks, transferring dozens of points from flat measurement drawings to 3D is not only time-consuming and challenging, but also inaccurate. Therefore, in 2007, we started ground-based laser scanning of rocks with traces of construction, a geodetic survey to obtain the most accurate and reliable data. We quickly created a model of the accessible part of the cliffs. However, many areas were not reachable due to the forest cover. Moreover, the top of the rocks was difficult to reach. So, to obtain inaccessible angles, laser scanning was complemented by photogrammetric surveying from a drone. Thus, the entire surface of the rocks was captured. After that, we combined the data to create a complete and detailed 3D model of the rocks with traces of construction, a digital copy of a large and complex physical object. By the way, this model can help to simulate the possible further destruction of rocks. We had to fit a fortress on the rock. The designer began to model the architecture based on Mykhailo Rozhko's drawings. Immediately, he faced problems. The buildings that were laid on the rocks had no internal communications. The structures of the five periods were simply not functional. There was a need of architectural elaboration. After that, all five periods of the fortress became harmonized with the rocks. An architectural building with a clear design, stairs, and levels. In the fifth period, by the way, there were 9 of them. Finally, in 2021, we completely reassembled the fifth period fortress in 3D by putting each wooden log into the hollowed out rock groove, testing the hypothesis suggested by Mykhailo Rozhko. We also recreated the layout and interiors of the fortress in its heyday. When arriving at the Tustan Cliffs, visitors always ask, where is the fortress? Augmented reality helped us to show it to them. The first application was created by students. In 2017, Softserve company developed an advanced operating version of Tustan AR for both Android and iOS platforms. Using the gadget, you can see a 3D model of the 5th century fortress by pointing it at the rocks. Such an innovation allowed every visitor to see the stronghold by downloading the app to their mobile device. To further develop this non-commercial product, the program code of the application is publicly available on GitHub. Softserve also developed a prototype of a virtual reality station, which we publicly presented at the Tustan Festival in 2018. Combining software and hardware with an environment, it allows users to see the fortress from above and from the sides. It is even possible to observe the courtyard during a realistic controlled flight on a hang glider. This way, visitors were able to virtually float over the fortress and view it from different angles. In 2021, the Tustan team was designing a game where players can wander inside the fortress and explore the daily life of the defenders. For this purpose, we recreated the interiors in detail with high-quality textures and lighting. Every day, Tustan visitors have the opportunity to virtually step inside and walk around the fortress wearing Oculus Quest 2 glasses. Augmented and virtual reality technologies enable Tustan to show visitors the lost architecture of the fortress without having to rebuild anything in reality. Recently, we also created a mobile application called Tustan Guide, which helps visitors navigate the destinations museum and tourist services. Using this app, they can also choose a cultural route around the territory and follow it. While traveling around the cliffs, you can listen to an audio guide, read information about locations, or see 3D models of museum objects that were found in a particular place during archaeological excavations. The mobile app is the basis of Tustan's digital transformation project, which combines the physical accessibility and the convenience of the destination's services with digital services. Since the beginning of Russia's full-scale war against Ukraine, the Tustan team was switched to saving heritage on a national scale, teaming up with 8 partners to form the professional initiative HeMo, Ukrainian Heritage Monitoring Lab. The expeditions to document the losses began with the rescue and 3D fixation of the famous kitchen cabinet with a ceramic rooster in Borodyanka on April 28, 2022. The church in the village of Vyazivka is an illustrative example of 3D modeling. A photogrammetric 3D model was made in the spring of 2022, and a detailed laser scan was made in the fall. Putting the models together, it was possible to track the dynamics of destruction and the movement of the dome. But while the method and cost of rescue were being considered, the church collapsed in the winter, and its detailed 3D model was the only thing left. Then, our expeditions became more complex and comprehensive, from information collection and verification to documenting the cultural heritage losses for its further restoration and criminal proceedings. Nowadays, we are creating reliable data. We document the destruction of Ukraine's cultural heritage by Russia during the war. We update the lists of museums and heritage sites in Ukraine. We store information in a database according to international standards. We provide this data to users, authorities, architects, and donors for rescue, stabilization, and restoration. Partners working with forensics to prosecute Russia, return stolen property, and restore justice. The military to take into account into operations and provide open access to the public and those interested on heritage in UA. To date, we have examined and documented over 900 sites in 15 regions of Ukraine. The second major focus of our work is the digitalization of museums. We have created the Museum Digitisation Centre Lviv, which has special equipment and a trained team to digitize collections of various types. We have also developed a program for electronic accounting of museum objects. By doing so, we help museums digitize their collections and automate processes according to international standards in order to make Ukrainian heritage accessible to Ukrainians and the world through digitalization. In addition to Tustan, we have already joined the digitization process of collections belonging to 4 more pilot museums: the State Museum of Natural History of the National Academy of Sciences of Ukraine, Kharkiv Literary Museum, Odessa National Art Museum, and the Bohdan and Varvara Khanenko National Museum of Art. Russia is attacking Ukraine's cultural heritage in the war. This exposes our systemic problems, which do not allow us to fully respond to the destruction, but also inspire us to an immediate transformation. Therefore, we must not only respond to the emergency, but also change the management system for the future. One of such fields is the digital transformation of the cultural heritage sector, which we are also working on. The complex problem of digitalization in Ukraine can only be solved through a systematic infrastructure approach. Rules and standards, authoritative data sets and metadata, hardware and software, organizational structure and human resources. This will allow not only to digitize heritage, but also to integrate different resources and data sets.